All right, the climactic opposite of everything we've been talking about, from fire to snow and lots of it. Mira Sorvino here, a movie based on a real story.
Yes. It's based on the real story of Eric Lamarck, who was a pro hockey player who became a methamphetamine addict and then got lost on a mountain snowboarding for 8 days in blizzard conditions. No one expected to find him alive, and this is his true story. It's incredibly riveting. The photography of the mountains with the snow and the snowboarding is incredible, but even deeper than that, it has this really important message about love. It's really the love between him and his mother, which I play, but caveat, I also play the mother of him as a small boy. So they needed somebody who could be the, you know, the mother of the 20-something-year-old character and then the mother of a 10-year-old. So that's me. It's weird because Josh and I are not really that far apart. But it works in the movie, and it's a beautiful story. It's just heartbreaking and inspiring. It's very inspiring.
We're gonna look at a clip in a minute that has some really, really good work in it. But I'm sort of laughing, but with empathy. That catch in your voice when you say, I play the mother, because there is that transition between ingenue roles, you know, certainly when you started out, and things like this. Did that, were you
making it better?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Trying.
Way to go, Sam.
No, well, that's a nice way to put it.
Don't worry. In my next project in Condor, I play a femme fatale who's basically seducing everybody in the movie and has no children. So,
all right.
There you go.
So, do you prefer one to the other, or are you comfortable with all different?
I'm comfortable with all of them. I mean, I got to meet the real Susan Lamarck, and she was such an inspirational person. Her love for her son and her unwillingness to say die, even when everybody had given up on him, and for her to keep the search going for him was truly powerful, and that's what I tried to bring to it. Her feelings of remorse that she sort of pushed him away when he's in the depths of his addiction and trying to be tough love about it, but then when he goes missing, she spearheads the search for him, and it's really quite extraordinary. Like, you will not leave without crying.
You have really very beautifully set up the clip we're about to show you. Look at this.
My son had a court date yesterday that he missed, okay? And that message that he left me, that was not normal. Him telling me where he was and what he was doing, he never does that, never. You wanna know why he did it? Because he was letting me know that he was gonna make it to the court date. He was getting it together. So when I walk into that courtroom and he is not there, and then I walk into that cabin and I see his clothes and old, congealed food sitting there and know him, I can't wait a day or two. And if he is out there in that snow on that mountain, neither can he.
Wow.
That is really, really good.
Did you have to battle conditions in the snow, or?
Me, no. My character is at the base while they're doing the search and rescue in the helicopter. So no, I got to be in sort of mostly warm indoor locations.
Good.
Yes. But Josh gives an incredible performance in this movie, and he has very few words. It's him and the mountain and these extreme circumstances, and some of them are quite frightful, but really compelling. I mean, it's a very compelling performance. Really beautiful work.
Mira, because you're here, I'm going to ask you to use the word extreme circumstances. This Harvey Weinstein story has gotten extraordinary attention. We're hearing from a lot of people about it. Do you have a thought about it?
I think it's high time that this came out. Within an hour or so, I have more to say on it in a publication that's on the record. I can't really talk about it right now because it hasn't broken yet. Mm-hmm. But you know, it's a travesty that this sort of behavior is normalized and accepted for decades in this industry. And I am very pleased that this is all coming to light. You know, these are very bad things that he did. And, you know, he has a lot of strengths. A lot of people admire him, including myself, for many of his talents. But this is not the way that men can act towards women anymore in this country. It is just not. And so the more all these cases come to light and the more people have the courage to speak out, the more that young women will be protected, and maybe we'll move into a future where my daughter is not going to have to be worried about being harassed on the job, and that it'll be a meritocracy. It will be based on her willingness to play ball with her male boss in order to get ahead and to be spurned and punished if she's not.
And do you think that this stuff, will we be hearing a lot more about it, whatever's coming out from you shortly?
I'm part of a much larger piece, but it's a pretty damning piece, and it's more serious than the New York Times one.
Wow.
It sounds like you've had some experience in dealing with him. I mean, I don't want you to break your
I can't really, yeah, right now. But I'm telling you, in an hour or so, you'll be, oh, okay. And you'll just read it and you'll be like, oh, okay.
I see.
Yeah. And then I'll be free to talk about it.
Well, we'll have you stay till 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
we'll tell you this.
We'll be here.
Six Below Miracle on the Mountain will be in select theaters on demand. The movie will open up October 13th. We appreciate you, Mira, talking about the movie and the other things as well.
Yeah, thank you, Mira. Good to see you this morning.